Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Newport, County Mayo, and what a glorious day we have got for it here today. And of course, it is the ancestral home of Michael Staines. And it was on this day, exactly 100 years ago to this very, very day, that Michael Staines led the first contingent of Gardaí through the gates of Dublin Castle to relieve what was the remains of the Royal Irish Constabulary and the British forces there. So it was a significant day in Irish history and a very significant day, I think you'd agree, in Garda history.
Newport is a place with a strong sense of community. People look after each other here. They have dignity, respect, honesty. They're disciplined, they're not afraid to face challenges here. And they work together to do what's right. And they're the values and the strengths that I believe Michael Staines would have brought from these shores and brought with him to An Garda Síochána. And they're the values and strengths that would have stood to us for the last 100 years and helped us to do our jobs and work with our communities. And it falls on us in An Garda Síochána to carry that torch first lit by Michael Staines and to live those values continuously.
And we've come together as a group in this very beautiful and appropriate location to commemorate one of the most important figures in the history of An Garda Síochána, Michael Staines. For me as a historian, I've always thought it's a little bit unfortunate that Michael is primarily known in the Garda context for having been the first commissioner and really little else, but that's a unique distinction in its own right. But I think what's perhaps far more important is the actions he took during his brief tenure as commissioner and what imprint he had left on the organisation. His final act as commissioner before General O'Duffy assumed command was to issue a three-page open letter to all civic guards before they left for their new stations. He said, "You are the pioneers of a new force, and the body will be judged by the few. You will become the objects of interest and criticism, both friendly and otherwise, and you must discharge your duties towards the general public, as will earn for you the respect, goodwill, and confidence of the people." And the knowledge that, as we stand here today, 100 years later, that the organization was founded and led by such inspirational figures as Michael Collins and Michael Staines, is something I think we can be justifiably proud of during our centenary year.
And I have to say that I'm very privileged to be here. I'm very privileged that I'm here representing my family and that I'm also here representing Michael Staines. His legacy, where's his legacy? Well, you don't have to look very far. His legacy is all around you. The Garda Síochána, as I said, they've had their ups and downs, but they have been a huge, huge positive force in this country and have ensured that this country has remained a democratic country and has remained a democratic country governed by the rule of law. And I think my grandfather would be very proud to look around and see what is here.
So it's a great pleasure to be with you all and in this most lovely place on what is this most perfect day as well. Commissioner Staines had an inspirational vision for our organisation. And that vision has gone on to define our policing presence here in Ireland and indeed has been emulated elsewhere in the world. His contribution to our organisation continues to be seen. In fact, it remains a part of the work of all Gardaí all across Ireland every single day. He moulded the tradition of unarmed policing by consent, and this has evolved into the present day An Garda Síochána and will define us for the years to come as well. This plaque here today in Newport will be a proud reminder to all of us who visit or call here home, the fine achievement in founding Ireland's first national policing service, An Garda Síochána. Thank you. Thank you very much.